Mr. Tarrou, I just wanted to drop in for a moment and give you a heartfelt, very sincere thank you. Thank you to all the thousands of students who watch my videos every month, who the many, many tens, if not hundreds of thousands of people that have subscribed to my channel and have given me support over the last 8 years, all the way back since August of 2011 when my hair was brown and I had no goatee. I love teaching. And I was inspired by some students way, way back when to get out a camera and start making some videos for YouTube. It's been awesome. With the help of YouTube and a camera on a tripod, I can do what I love and help people learn math all over the world. It's awe-inspiring, humbling, and I'm extremely grateful. Now I say that, but if you look at my channel on a regular basis, or just maybe you're seeing it for the first time now, I haven't posted a math video for the last 10 months. I'm not bored, discouraged, or tired. I'm not over YouTube. I'm just simply too busy. When I started my YouTube channel, I taught pre-calculus and AP statistics and Algebra 1, and I got inspired, like I said, to start making videos for pre-calc and statistics. And I made a lot of videos that first year. Then, just to make sure there was very clear and continuous separation between what I was doing at my public high school and this YouTube channel, I got this nice chalkboard and started making videos at home. I loved making videos for YouTube so much, and it had bothered me after so many years of teaching that I had forgotten so much calculus that I started making videos just for YouTube because I love, you know, making content for you all, and I love the feeling of relearning math that I had long forgotten because I've been teaching for like 18 or something years and probably over 20 years since I'd seen calculus, and it really bothered me that I forgot so much calculus. So I started relearning it between the classes that I was teaching. That process and relearning of calculus, developing videos for YouTube, is what opened the door for me to teach AP Calculus AB at my high school. It's kind of like when I was working at Publix as a kid, and as I was in college, I was looking for a full-time position. My boss said, you know, look, if you want to be full-time, if you want to be promoted, you have to first be a full-time employee. Be on time, dress appropriately, act appropriately, you know, show me that you are a full-time employee and I will promote you to that position. You know, basically make your own destiny. I started relearning calculus for the love of math and for the love of YouTube, and when I was near the end of relearning that content, some scheduling issues were showing up at my school, and they knew that I had calculus fresh in my mind, and so when there was an opportunity to teach the AP calculus course at my school as opposed to a teacher that was in the IB program, a little magnet school within our big public high school, because of that scheduling conflicts, they offered it to me, and we went with it, and I've had really good success with those traditional students and that AP Calculus program. Well, when I got done with that AB content, I just kept going, and I kept learning more and more calculus until I got into the sequences and series of near the end of Calc 2 or Calc BC, and man, I was like, this is too hard just to do this for YouTube. I do not make enough money. It's just a hobby. Teaching is my career. And I put that on pause until this absolutely wonderful teacher, I have huge shoes to fill, but this teacher at our school, highly respected, I love dearly, it was time to retire. And again, because I had prepared myself, not necessarily for that position, but just continued my relearning and expansion of calculus knowledge for you all out there in YouTube land, along with teaching AP statistics, my school felt comfortable enough with me to offer me her position after she retired. So last year was my first year ever of teaching IB, math in the IB program, in the International Baccalaureate program. And the lady that retired, She didn't teach the standard level stuff. She taught the HL math, the high level mathematics. And that meant that I had to go back, finish learning the rest of Calculus BC, and now I'm doing it for me, for my career, and for the students I'm going to be teaching in my classroom. That's why a year ago you started seeing a rush of Algebra 2 or Algebra BC content on my channel. And that is why the content just stopped. Because I had never taught Calculus BC before live. The seniors in that HL math program, while their textbook read by the table of contents as a mostly review book, the difficulty at which the content was written for the IB exams was a huge challenge for me. So I had to finish doing solutions for the BC content so that, you know, I'm not a natural mathematician. I'm not a math wizard, a genius. I don't have numbers and formulas and graphs floating around in my head. I have to work really very, very hard to comprehend higher level math. So I did every single problem in that senior year HL math book. I've done that actually for all the calculus material I've covered for my class and for you all as well. So I was finishing BC work. I was working throughout that entire HL math book. I also taught calculus AB, pre-calculus, and I was teaching calculus class AB in our traditional program. So I kind of had five preps, sort of four, kind of five. It was four different subjects, but one was the AB was on two different schedules. So I had a lot of work, and it was the absolute best teaching experience probably in my life overall. I mean, I've always had standout kids and maybe a standout class, but it reinvigorated my already a love for teaching, but I've been teaching 23 years now, and it's given me a whole new start to my career and just re-energized me for the remaining seven of my 30 years that I'll be teaching. Then I'm going to retire and probably take on YouTube full time, redoing some of my content, maybe doing some streaming tutoring, or I don't know. But it's a long way down the road, I'm kind of rambling here. But I just wanted to say I have not made new content because I've been learning math for the courses that I'm teaching, plus doing what I do. I did five practice multiple choice tests for BC. I worked through 10 years of BC FRQs. I did two time zones for each of the three tests at the end of the year my HL math kids have to take. So I did, like, I think that was five or six years of IB exams. Test paper one, paper two, and paper three. Paper one and two both have a time zone one and time zone two. So I have learned a lot and got to work with some incredibly motivated and intelligent students that have, wow, they're going to be the engineers and doctors and whatever else, the people that lead us tomorrow. It's really, really awesome. So through this next year, you can expect to see a video playlist developed for vectors. I'm working on that today and for quite a while. I learned a couple new types of differential equations to solve. I just went to another AP training and learned a few little things I need to tweak for my AP classes and how I can improve those. I'll be bringing that to you. And after I get finished with the vector videos, you can expect more videos for about one more school year that are going to be focused on, say, like IB style math questions. I need to find out if I can actually do and share the released IB exams with you. If not, I'll try and do my best to make up some questions inspired by some of those test problems and give some shorter format videos, maybe around the 10, 15, 20 minute mark, as opposed to full lessons on my channel that can sometimes be 30, 40, 50 minutes to an hour and a half. And hopefully allow you to continue your math studies and help you be successful in whatever path that you choose in life. But I just want to say in parting, you know, you will make your destiny. If you want something, go after it. Make it happen, even if initially you're doing it for free. Because when I first started YouTube, I wasn't making any money. Nobody knew who I was. Many people still don't, but thankfully a few more do now. And a lot of people said, you know, why aren't you just tutoring? Why are you making all of these videos and busting your butt after hours when you're not at school and you're not grading papers, you're not doing lesson plans? Why are you making all these videos on YouTube when it takes up so much of your time for nothing? Well, thankfully, you have allowed me into your home, your computer, your phone, into your classroom, and allowed me to help you learn math. And that has created, you know, a small income stream for me, a sense of, more importantly, a sense of purpose and gratitude for allowing me to help you. But that just doing something that I loved, teaching math, something I'm passionate about, and just doing something a little bit differently, something a little bit on the side, has opened up more doors for me. Doors that I never expected to be available in my career. And now I get to continue making more videos for you. Hopefully you continue to spread the word, subscribe, like, share. And not only am I now teaching AP Calculus AB, AP Calculus BC, which I give a lot of credit to you all and to this opportunity of YouTube, but in this IB program. And maybe now I can open up my channel to even more students, more international students, more honor students, more maybe even college students in this higher level content that you can see coming from me in the next year. Now, why am I only saying a year? Because in the next, not this next school year, but the one afterwards, we're getting new textbooks. I'm getting a new IB book. That means all new solutions. I have to do a lot of prep for my classes, so I make sure that I can cover the material effectively in class. So there might be a little bit of a one-year sort of, again, gap of much new content, but that's going to be because I'm doing so much work for my actual career, my actual job, and my live students, and then I'll come back again, and as often as possible, continue to make videos, math lessons for you, and yeah, who knows, maybe there'll be occasional how-to video for woodworking or my car. But anyway, I'm Miss True. Thank you so, so very much. Bam. Go do your homework.